Hey folks, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS with a look at Mega Bloks Halo set number 97118 with 518 pieces officially. This is called the Cauldron Clash. Now for a lot of Mega Bloks Halo fans, this set is the introduction to the Prometheans and the real Halo 4 specific world. And the big news here is that we get the Prometheans featuring an actual pre-Promethean knight. So I'm going to spend a lot of time looking at the figures, especially since if you're looking at this in the future, you might not know that this is the first Mega Bloks set that I have reviewed. So we'll look at the figures first, and then we'll take a look at the structure in the background. All right, let's start from the left, starting with this Marine. It's a UNSC Marine, just your regular plain foot soldier. Has a pretty decent facial mold on him, actually. I think looks pretty serious and pretty professional, not very cartoonish. Some of the Mega Bloks figures have had a little bit of a cartoonish head to them, especially with the humans in particular, but this one works out okay. He has a DMR, and of course you can swap the weapons around. I'm not a big fan of this particular incarnation of a DMR. The way that Mega Bloks molded it with the long guard in front of the pistol grip. And I realize the pistol grip is important to connect to the hands, but I think they took away a little bit of the kind of signature look of the DMR itself. My favorite weapon in Halo, though. He does have an accessory on the back, just a backpack, general use. Doesn't have anything that you can take out of it. And this has all of the standard articulation that a Mega Bloks figure would have. So the head, shoulders, and upper thighs or hips are all on ball joints, so you can rotate. I'm going to turn this. You can rotate in and out in addition to flaying out and in addition to all of your normal up and down. Head the same, can twist a little bit to the side, a little bit to the side, not so much, but can definitely go up and down, so that's really good for animation if you want to do stop motion. Can turn the head all the way, either way, get lots of looks. You know, it's very, very lively. Of course, you've got elbow joints here. You've got your wrist that you can turn. The hands have five fingers on them. And you also have waist articulation right there. Oops, accidentally popped off. You can really get some very dynamic poses with these guys. And they've got a very generous, open, space on the bottom of the foot that fits over more than just one single peg, so you can kind of slide that forward and back across a stud a little bit, and you can definitely get a lot of friction on it and get some interesting poses if you're on a surface that has studs. If you're not, still the feet are large enough that he's able to stand up pretty effectively even with a long weapon. Spartan with the soldier armor. I think the scale is a little bit off here, unfortunately. It would have been nice if the Spartans were taller than the regular normal human characters, the non-engineered human characters, but that's okay. It still looks good as a figure itself, and I think they really did a great job of capturing that soldier armor, and I think they used kind of an ink-like paint or print for the main armor color here, because it has a lot of depth. And it's not just one flat color. You can definitely see darkness in the little indentations around the pockets and everything. A lot of depth, a lot of shape. Really looks good, you know, just by itself. This guy here obviously is carrying a railgun. I think that the use of the pistol grip for the railgun does not detract from its look overall. As you can see, you can get the nice two-handed pose holding onto the railgun, so that's really good. The face looks really good. They got the shape of the visor with the gold paint in there, pretty nicely done. That works out well. It's not over-painted beyond the edges, so it has that really sinister, serious look. And for the Spartan, or you could use it for the Marine or for any of the others, but they also give you this little platform, a little bit of terrain, with the transparent pieces that will hold him up, the clip in the back. So he's got his hole in the back so you can show him jumping, or imagine he had a jet pack or something, get some more dynamic poses out of him in the air, like so. Prometheans, hello, Prometheans. Start with the crawlers. crawlers get two that are absolutely identical. I think they look pretty good. The thing that is most off with these is that the paws are extra large, really, really large, compared to the ones in the game. However, they did that so that they would have actual holes for studs on the bottom. And those allow you, I'm just going to bring this piece of terrain in again, to do some interesting poses where, again, you've got ball joints on everything, so everything can completely twist around as far as the legs are concerned. But you can imagine one of these guys jumping from above, and you can get poses like that. How awesome is that, where he's just jumping down and still trying to leap forward. Don't have articulation down here at the wrist or at the ankles, but I think it still works out okay, because that's really, really cool there. Ball joint underneath the head. The only familiar pose that you're not able to get out of the crawlers here, I think, is the one where he's close down to the ground, kind of in the crouching dog kind of look, with the head facing up. The head just does not turn up enough to get that kind of look, but everything else is pretty good. And you get two of those guys included here. Next up, a watcher. I thought they did a really good job with the watcher, because it has all of the appendages. He has the little vestigial hands or arms in the front. He's got the legs that hang down. He's got these kind of wing elements up here. A little bit of a face in there, just a little bit, still captured. And you got the nice color with the orange translucent back here. For what it is, they did a really good job with this one. And there's even more to it, which I'll show you in a minute when we're looking at the big character here, the Promethean Knight. Now, again, with scale, I think the scale is off here. I don't think that there should be that much of a difference between a human and a knight. Certainly not that much of a difference in the height between a Spartan and a knight. But, you know, I'm okay with it, because all the stuff that they let you do, some interesting things with the knight, I think works out great. Look at all the panels that are open on the back, and those are actually articulated. You can turn them, each one individually, all five of these. He's got a face in there. They were able to get a little bit of print down into the eyes to get that orange color, a little bit of glow. Got the shape of him, I think, really well. Got the vibro blade over here. He's got a scatter shot built into his arm on this side, and then he's got the little vestigial arms in the center. These can each hold weapons or other accessories. They don't clip on all that hard, but they will hold them. However, these inside arms only go straight up and straight down. They don't have ball joints like the shoulders have ball joints. The elbows, just single axis joints. Ball joint in the head, so you can make him look down. He doesn't look up very well, so when he's angling forward, he's not able to really look up. You saw I just pulled that off accidentally. All rubber. Rubber pieces there, except for the inside. This here is the harder plastic. This here is the harder plastic. Everything else is rubber. In the legs, you've got ball joints, but there's not a whole lot of articulation going in and out there. It's mostly just the forward and back motion. And then the knees also looks really good, but not a whole lot you can do with the posability with these guys. However, the great thing about this one is that this is a carrier. This knight is a carrier. And that watcher, let's do this. Pull this piece off here. Drop that in on those two pegs, there and there. Take this watcher and all of his articulation and all of his limbs, just fold all those straight back, down, under, straight back. And now this is going to go right there. See if I can get that to clip in place, like so. Yep, there he goes. Let me get him centered. He's nice and centered right in there. Now you can take all these panels, close them down, click, click, click. Fits pretty nicely. There's just a tiny bit of gap on that side. Works out okay. And there you have your carrier knight, who now has a watcher inside. And you can deploy that watcher whenever you want. So you don't have to have the watcher out at all times, or just kind of hide it when you don't want it to be on the battlefield. That's great. You know, that's really what you're used to seeing in the game, and I think they've captured it really well. So kudos to him for making what's a good character. The only thing I don't like about it is the size is a little bit off. It does weigh a lot, but you can get the balance right. I just didn't get the balance right. And these do have 1x2 stud connections on the base. Let's look at the structures. All right, the cauldron. It's an area that has lots of lava flowing underneath of it. And for that reason, they gave you a lot of the translucent red and orange pieces, which you put together down here on the base. And you can see they're kind of flowing underneath. That did take a long time to assemble with all the different colors and different sizes that they use under there. It was a little bit annoying, but I think the result is kind of worth it. But they got a very, very random look. There's not a lot of patterning in there, so I think that's pretty cool, but it definitely does take some time. Most of the parts of the platform are made with either gunmetal gray or silver, the nice pearly silver, which is pretty appropriate. I think the silver is a little more tech kind of looking, a little more metallic looking than the stuff in the game, but I think it's probably the closest match that they have in their color scheme. The terrain down here has the multiple colors with the dark tan and a little bit of marbling of black coming into it kind of randomly. You've got a ramp over here on the side, kind of a sneak attack back route in. You would expect that as you approach this, there would be a knight protecting it right from kind of the center location right there. So you can try to flank him from the side, or you can try to do a direct attack. You can go underneath here with the two ramps that go up, so you can choose which way to go. It's oftentimes a place that the crawlers will be coming down from above. You've got a ramp directly in the front. If you try to do a direct assault, the route is going to be blocked. However, they do have a little action here to help you to unblock that. If you've got some heavy weaponry, you should be able to take that out. And this is how that works, like so. It's supposed to actually fall down. Yeah, there he goes. So you kind of jump over that. Or you can imagine that you hit it with a harder weapon, and hopefully this would actually really pop out. There you go, that's even better. Leaves a little bit, this doesn't naturally want to close itself back up, so it's kind of like damage to the terrain or to the structure. I'm okay with that. I think that works out pretty well. And then as you go in, you can see you've got some lights on the floors. They're not inset. Would have been nice if the lights on the floors were actually inset into the floor a little bit, but it's okay. You know, it does get the look across. And then the tower is the big deal back here, and that looks really nice. And take the knight back out of the way. It's my favorite part of this entire structure, is this tower. A very simple, very easy build. It gets a little bit repetitive with the pattern of the black section here, but you can see that these side pieces are attached from the sides. Allows you to have just that little streak of the nice orange glow coming through there. You can see those parts do capture the light very nicely. And there, right there, we can see straight through to the white behind. Very nice. And the same thing on the top, just kind of continues the color across. So I think they did a good job with the set. The design of it, the part choice, and the color choice, I think worked out pretty well with this one. And they do give you this little stand, I forgot to mention it, the transparent stand, which is intended to be a spot for a watcher to sit. So I'll go ahead and redeploy the watcher over here. And this is just a standard size peg right there, so that holds that up. And you can, of course, move that around and have it, you know, deployed in different locations. So I think that's nice. And then they also give you, like I showed you earlier, the one similar thing, a little bit shorter, with a clip on the top for allowing you to change the angle, so you can put that onto the back of a figure that has a hole in the back of it. Overall, this worked out quite well for the first Mega Block set that I've reviewed. I think that I chose a good one. It's pretty fun. The thing that's most exciting to me about the entire set is the Promethean Knight. Hope that they release more of those, preferably in little battle packs, just separately, so you don't have to get the entire set. Good news is that the entire thing, all of this together, is between $40 and $50 US, and with 518 pieces plus all of these figures, I think it's a pretty good deal. I wouldn't mind if it was a little bit cheaper, but hey, everything could be cheaper, right? You could give it to us for free. That would be the best. But overall, I'm pretty satisfied with it. The quality of the figures is great. Quality of the parts was respectable. Everything fit together pretty well. I've had pretty consistent engagement of the parts, and I do like the colors, and I do like the marbling in the pretty nicely shaped and dimensioned terrain pieces. So that does it for this review. Thank you very much for watching. Oh wait, there's one more thing that I forgot to mention here. The extra pieces that are included with the set. That's a lot of extra pieces that are going to really allow you to customize stuff. And if you have other battlescape elements from Mega Bloks Halo series, you get a lot of these kind of lava looking pieces that you can integrate and you know, do some custom stuff, add some different types of terrain to your own existing sets and your existing play setups. So that's pretty cool and pretty generous of them. So that's it for real this time. Talk to you again soon.